other day we went to Belfast with Marisa and the engines start doing strange things. It dropped in revs, twice. Twice it dropped in revs, so much that it seems like it was going to stall. And then it recovered. But then on the way back it did it once alone. So I think it's the famous diesel book. So what I am going to do is, what do they call it here? Clean the diesel, polish the diesel. I'm going to polish the diesel. And I do this with an invention that I saw Patrick Laine do as well. And I'm going to see if... I did it on the other boat, so I know it works. Let's hope it's just that. And change the filters, okay? Okay, this is the diesel polisher that I use. And here is the inlet with a copper tube. The inlet continues through this tube to the first filter. And from there to the water separator. There is another 30 micron filter in here, which I will later change to a 10 micron. I might do 3 hours and 3 hours. So, here's a hand pump to bleed the electric pump. And here's the electric pump, okay? And I have this connected to a fuse that I put here behind for safety. And to the switch, okay? And all this is connected, well, the pump is connected to the boat battery by a 12 volt input. And this is the final result. If you watch the video, you can see what the diesel looks like. This is the diesel at the end of the process, once polished, after going through this system. And the copper tube allows me to scrap the bottom of the tank. The polisher is just a water separator, pump and filter. Now let's see if I can access the tank, which is the most difficult part, because it's down there. Then I'll see if I can open where the sensor is. I may be able to open where the sensor is and insert the tube there to clean. I removed the screws and the first thing I see, look, the first thing I see is that the gauge, this is totally broken. This is the contact for the gauge for the amount of diesel. And this one moves erratically. The needle did like this. It was probably a bad contact. So this contact, when we finish with the diesel, we will change it. And we will see if the indication goes better. Now let's remove this. That's it. We leave it here. And through this hole we will try to put the inlet pipe. And the outlet pipe through the outlet. I mean through the inlet. And then let it recirculate. Let all the diesel recirculate. And filter it. And then depending of the color of the diesel and the color of the filter, I will know if it is very bad or not. I use a copper tube to make it a little rigid and be able to reach the bottom and scrape and clean the bottom. I don't have too much space here, but I'll try to move it around a little bit. As you can see, I have a ground connection, which is probably not necessary, with a plastic tank. It's a bit excessive, overkilling, as they say around here, but just in case, so that we don't get a spark or something. I previously worked in aircraft maintenance, and we always connected the pump to the tank, so that there was no voltage difference. Although it is only diesel, and there should be no problem, but safety never hurts. Well, the party has already started, and the first thing I did was, with this manual pump, prime the electric pump. And I've already put the inlet pipe here, and I put the old lead pipe there at the tank filling inlet, and it's already circulating. Do you see? And you see the filter? It's already full of crap. So what I do is move this here around, and as I move it, more crap comes out. And we are going to wait and see if this is the whole problem. Okay, we'll be changing this filter soon, and we'll keep going. I think the pump moves 70 liters per hour. I have about 140 liters, so that's about 2 hours. We'll do about 4 or more. And here we can see how the filter diesel returns to the tank. Do you see it? I don't know if it appears on camera. So it is circulating. Little by little. It's a matter of patience. And changing filters. As you can see, the problem is certainly here. Diesel book is a microbial growth in diesel fuel that can damage engines and equipment. Diesel book is often caused by water entering the fuel tank, which can happen because biodiesel attracts water, or by condensation itself. Water has a higher density than diesel. This orange thing that you see is a float. It floats in water but sinks in diesel, and is used to see, in case that the diesel is very clear, the difference between diesel and water. In this case, we don't need it, because the pollution is also below, mixed with the water. Look at the appearance of the pre-filter. It's bad, and it's the third one we use. And here is the water separation. It's a disaster. This diesel is a disaster. And I still don't understand how the engine hasn't stopped completely. Thank God we caught it in time. And it hasn't given us a real problem. That would be to stop at the entrance to a marina. Or next to some rocks. Well, we'll clean it well. Take out all the water, change the filters, and that's it. So we'll change this filter. It's loose already. Okay. Oh, yeah. Great. Okay. You can see anything really in this filter, you know. Okay, you see the difference? So of course, because it's not pre-filter, so everything goes to this one. So I think that was the problem. Well, here I say that there is no pre-filter, but this is the pre-filter. Okay. It is important to lubricate the O-rings with diesel before putting the new filter. That's it. Will it be enough? Yeah?
We'll see, we'll put the motor on and we'll see. It's an electric. That's it. Have to pump now. The pump is here. And then maybe pump a bit here. Can you see the filter if you get it full?
There's a pump.
No.
That's here. Okay. Check now.
Yep, coming in.
Bring the camera. Full?
Nope.
To remove the air from the system, first remove the screw that is normally located above the engine filter. When then primed manually, using the lever on the left pump. Until the diesel comes out through the screw hole. Everything seems fine. Let's try it in the sea.
Okay, sea trial. Estoy probando el motor.
We are testing the engine after cleaning the diesel and changing the filters, and everything looks good.
Tengo una mica más de vueltas ahora.
A little more reps to see.
Bueno.
No.
Hola. Todo bien.
All good. We don't have any wind, but that's perfect because we just want to test the engine. Well, perfect. If it doesn't fail, of course.
Not bad.
What a fantastic day. What a pity. We could have been sailing. But we have to do this diesel thing, just to be safe. But oh well. We'll have it sorted out for next week. There's not much wind, so we couldn't have gone very far with the sails. There is Ian. Is he asleep? I hope he's holding on tight. I had to make a video of this because it's beautiful. What a sunset! You probably can't see it properly on camera, but it's fantastic. It might be. Before finishing, I would like to show you the difference between the diesel before and after being filtered. So you can see that this process really works. I have not been able to clean the walls of the tank, so I will carry out this process again next year. and I will add the additive recommended by my local chandler to eliminate the bacterium. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. If so, don't forget to subscribe. We have lots of plans to get Marisa ready for next season. See you soon, amigos!